You're listening to The Alex Jones Show. Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
And it had to do with the stepfather of Michael Brown, who said, burn this down, talking about the town of Ferguson, leading into the events of last week. My question is, do you believe those comments should be pursued? Is that inciting a riot?
We are pursuing those comments, and there's a lot of discussion going on about that right now, but I really can't get into that at this time.
Is there an atmosphere where maybe there's a group in law enforcement, maybe in the prosecutor's office, arguing that, oh, we should just let it die? But wouldn't that just encourage people in the future to act the same way and feel that they could get away with it?
No, we can't let all that happened in Ferguson and Delwood and the community die. Everyone who is responsible for taking away people's property, their livelihoods, their jobs, their businesses, every single one of them needs to be prosecuted to the full extent of the law.
What about back in August when this happened, Chief?
All my colleagues then.
Did you use the videotape then to go after people?
We did.
Yeah. Okay.
You know, let's go to this other case, because it's funny, whenever you have one of these cases, it doesn't become a big national story. The media chose a loser like Brown, who is strong-arming a store over cigars, probably to make blunts with, and thugging out, and was it too extreme what the cop did? I don't know. He says he got assaulted, and then he charged him again. Whatever, the whole world doesn't revolve around this. It's like a drama queening. Bad stuff happens all the time. People, I probably know 6-7 people that have, like, schizophrenic brothers or sisters. In fact, I had it happen to some distant family, not too distant, but the husband of my great aunt, who just died recently, you know, her second husband after her death. The point is, his daughter had schizophrenia or a mental disorder and freaked out, and the cops came to her house. She was unarmed. They shot her, thinking she was armed. I mean, is we just the whole world going to be burned down because of it? There's just countless examples of mentally ill people that I've known or people that I know that know them who get killed by the police. That's another thing. I wouldn't just call the cops unless you really got an emergency going on. Because you don't know what's going to happen. You don't know if you're going to get a bad cop. You don't know if you're going to get a stupid cop, a scared cop. It's a dangerous situation. People call the cops now if their McDonald's cheeseburger is cold. That was a real case. Or if their son or daughter, their five-year-old's not doing what mommy says, you call the police. Well, we have the case here. We're going to talk more about it later. In Staten Island, of Eric Gardner. Garner. Being choked to death. And he's just got his hands up talking to the police going, hey, hey, hey. I don't, you know, need to be arrested. Blah, blah, blah. Boom, they get him. They slam him down. And everybody's seen this where the person's not resisting the cop. And they say, get on the ground. They throw you down and go ahead and jump on your back with their knees or jump on your head or knock your head in the ground. I've been arrested a few times demonstrating. And in every case but once, they knock my head into things and shove me around and put the handcuffs on too tight. And then one time I went down to the Travis County Jail. The one time they didn't rough me up, the state police didn't rough me up. And when I get there, this little short redhead guy goes, oh, Alex Jones, you really think you're something, huh? Turn around. And shoved my face and nose enough to give me a bruise into the wall. And he was like, oh, you got to do something? You got to do something? I mean, so obviously a bunch of cowardly nobodies try to get jobs like that. Not everybody. But there's that factor in there. There's that element. And I don't know why it's allowed to flourish. We're all upset about that, those of us that want justice. But Brown ain't it. And it's all a big globalist UN program to stir up division in this country and to legitimize killing white people with hammers. I mean, this is getting crazy. For months, the InfoWars Life Silver Bullet Colloidal Silver has been completely sold out. Now, we have finally procured a limited supply from one of the leading manufacturers of nutraceuticals in the nation. But here's what's truly exciting. While we could simply sell the Survival Silver for its already discounted shelf price, we have decided to give back to you, the listeners, who make it all possible with a pre-Black Friday mega sale. We are launching this mega special with an unprecedented 20% off and free shipping on all Silver Bullet across the board, while supplies last, and to help everyone stock up before the next shortage. When you buy four bottles of Silver Bullet, you will receive the fifth one absolutely free. That's on top of the 20% off savings and free shipping. Finally, if supplies hold, we will extend this special out to Cyber Monday. Ladies and gentlemen, we've never done anything like this before. Find this mother of all specials and others I have not yet announced yet at InfoWarsStore.com or call 888-253-3139. That's InfoWarsStore.com.
The government's Department of Homeland Security is buying up loads of ammo. At the same time, they're restricting civilians' rights to own and purchase firearms. Can you put two and two together? Infidel Body Armor can stop every round, including hollow points and 308 sniper rounds, is reasonably priced and fully legal. But for how long? Go to InfidelBodyArmor.com, spelled I-N-F-I-D-E-L, BodyArmor.com. Infidel Body Armor just won't quit.
The average person's life is filled with unexpected challenges. Unlock the energy it takes to defeat these daily beasts with Super Male or Super Female Vitality, specifically designed to assist the body in regulating proper hormone balance to create superior vitality in males and females. Supercharge and conquer your world at InfoWarsLife.com or call 1-888-253-3139.
On the eve of Thanksgiving this year, I was thinking, what am I really thankful for? And I got to tell you, it's my family, it's all the blessings of liberty that our forebears secured, and it's you, the listeners of the broadcast, who've made everything we do possible. This Black Friday, I decided to bring you the biggest special we've ever offered on any of the nutraceuticals at InfoWarsLife.com. I'm talking about Silver Bullet Colloidal Silver that we've been sold out of for months. This time, I doubled down and got even more. As of me taping this, on the eve of Thanksgiving, we have already sold half of it. So instead of keeping the price at its regular discounted price, we are going to give you 20% off and free shipping on single bottles. But if you get four bottles, we're going to give you the fifth one free and the free shipping. I don't know how long this special will run, but if supplies last, we will extend it out until Cyber Monday. You'll find powerful nutraceuticals like Silver Bullet and others at InfoWarsLife.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139. Again, this is Alex Jones wishing you all a blessed and happy Thanksgiving and thanking you all for your support of freedom.
From his Central Texas Command Center, deep behind enemy lines, the information war continues. It's Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
Well, we're joined by the head of Liberty Guard that's fighting against the police state nationwide. And what the TSA is up to. He's also a former congressman, and he's the man that introduced the impeachment articles against William Jefferson Clinton. And, of course, he's former Congressman Bob Barr. He was way ahead in polls, and I thought he was going to get in that district in Georgia, outside Atlanta, but he lost to the Tea Party candidate. And it's kind of a paradox because I'm a big Tea Party guy. But I knew that Bob Barr, on almost every issue, was an outsider. He was exposing the NSA, the police state, fighting against gun control, and you know, trying to impeach Bill Clinton whenever the establishment didn't want that. So, whereas I think the candidate that beat him is a fine person, it shows how powerful the huge backlash was against any incumbent, even though Barr wasn't an incumbent and had been out of Congress for a while. I wanted Barr to be in there because he would start the impeachment. He said, boom, first day. Now Obama says he's going after the guns using UN treaty, not law. He says he's shutting off more power plants. He's doing naked amnesty. He is putting our troops under more NATO UN control across the board, acting unilaterally. and he's got 2 years left. So I want to talk to Bob Barr first about briefly about his election to see if he concurs with what I just said. And then I want to get into the UN saying not just the people of America need to be disarmed, but the police as well. See, only the UN under their memorandum 7277 and UNESCO that they believe is law, even if we don't ratify it, only the UN has the weapons. How creepy is that? And that's the headline at Infowars.com, UN attacks U.S. gun rights and more, citing Ferguson and the police. In my mind, and we'll talk about this as well, there's no doubt that they're trying to cause racial division, riots in America, because that's all Obama's got. And we'll have Bob Barr put on his former CIA hat and his former federal prosecutor hat to ask where he thinks all this is going. But the NFL, the Black Caucus in Congress, holding up their hands, don't shoot, implying that white people inherently want to kill black people and that police inherently are involved in police shootings and are guilty for what another cop does. I mean, this is race class warfare right out of the Joe Stalin book, in my view. Now, that's a mouthful. Again, Congressman, former Congressman Bob Barr joins us. Let's go through all those points, sir. But first off, the election, the Tea Party victories. What do you think that says to the establishment?
Well, first of all, Alex, great to be with you and your listeners once again. It's always great to get into these topics with you, because not only do you understand them, but your listeners do as well. They understand the importance of the fundamental principles that that we're talking about here. It was a strange election, not only in my race for the 11th district here in Georgia, but in a couple of other races in Georgia, and I noticed elsewhere as well. Anybody who had any experience or prior service in Washington, such as I did, having served, as you mentioned, as the first to call for William Jefferson Clinton to be impeached back in the mid and late 1990s, anybody who had any experience up there was labeled, as my opponent labeled me, as the establishment. Now, anybody who knows me knows that, I'm anything but the establishment, but that was a truly a deciding factor. Jack Kingston, for example, even though Jack Kingston, former member of the Appropriations Committee, and he was and is still a sitting member of Congress, he gave up his House seat to run for the Senate. And I think he suffered the same thing, even though he truly was an incumbent. But there still are a lot of issues out there. I remain just as committed to fighting for the Constitution and the causes that and the principles that it represents as you do. Whether I'm in office or not, I certainly would have enjoyed serving the people of America once again in the House, to use the the background, the experience that I have, to fight against increases in government power and limitations on individual liberty. Didn't get that chance this time, but I'm continuing to fight the good fight from the private sector.
Well, sure. I mean, it'd be like not voting for Ron Paul if he ran again, because he'd already been in there. I mean, I see it as overall a positive sign that people are really fed up, but it still shows that they're not overall educated, though, on how to, in some cases, go with somebody that has experience and will actually go after people. I mean, as a prosecutor, I would guess that's why you had the cojones to do that. I mean, it's obviously dangerous to try to impeach a sitting president, especially Slick Willie. And these new Tea Party people that have gotten in, they better deliver or they're going to be in deep trouble with their constituents.
You're absolutely correct, and I love the Tea Party movement. I think it's very healthy. We have some very strong Tea Party groups here in Georgia. I mean, Jenny Beth Martin, the head of Tea Party Patriots, is here in Georgia, and got her start in politics working in one of my campaigns back in 2002. But there are some folks that are involved with the Tea Party that just don't quite understand that we need to use those Tea Party values in conjunction with people who know how to move them forward. At the same time as we need people up in Washington who have the courage to